Welcome to NAFC-TV's Moving Forward. I'm Diane Williamson. Happy 4th of July. We hope you're having a wonderful summer break so far. Last semester, I got a tip that we had an incredibly talented composer hanging out at Hazelwood Middle School, but he was so elusive, it was the last day of school before I was able to track him down for an interview. Meet Maestro Thomas Cropper, musical composer whose inspiration came from, well, he doesn't really know.
I don't really know. I really don't know. Honestly, I just got a few notes stuck in my head and I figured I'd try to write them down. And then I stayed after school one day to work on it on the computer we have in the band room, and Mr. Jones came walking up and he was like, "What's that?" And I showed him and he thought it sounded good, and it just kind of went from there. Well, a couple years ago I kind of dreamed about it, and then I lost it before I could write it down, and like 6 months ago it came back again, so I'm like, why not try and take it this time? I've been doing all kinds of music stuff since like fourth grade. I did choir in fourth grade, orchestra in fifth grade, and I've been doing band ever since.
Band director Eugene Jones was very instrumental in helping young Maestro Cropper with the composition.
It's Guardians Roar, and he just came in to the band room one day and he said, "Mr. Jones, what do you think about writing a piece, helping me write a piece for the band?" And at first I was hesitant because that's like an English teacher getting a student to come up to them with a short story and they'll be like, "Can you help me write a novel?" He came after school multiple times to work on it. He worked on it late at night, and I've constantly been revising it with him, several drafts. And when it came time to pass it out to the class, he actually did something really neat, and that was he didn't want them to know that he wrote it, because he wanted to see how they would react. Then the concert came, and I revealed it to the audience and the kids, and they were floored. They couldn't believe it. So he got like three standing ovations, you know, because and quite a few of these kids said it was their favorite piece that they've ever played in band.
Thomas will be a freshman this semester at New Albany High School and plans to continue his musical career, so stay tuned. The NAFC Education Foundation is hosting their 6th annual Play FORE Education Golf Scramble on Friday, July 18th. It's at Champions Point Golf Course in Henryville. The proceeds from this event will help to provide essential classroom resources for teachers and students in NAFC schools. We would love for your team of four to join us, or if you would like, whole sponsorships are still available. Just go to their website for more information. We're always looking for story ideas, so if you have a great story to tell about your school, please let us know about it. And you can stay up to date during the summer months by visiting our website, liking our Facebook page, and following us on Twitter and Instagram at NAFC Success. I'm Diane Williamson. We'll see you next week on Moving Forward.